friends, I am Dr. Avilash Nayak. I welcome all of you to this MOOC on Academic Counseling for ODL Learners. In this video, we shall discuss formative assessment and summative assessment. Assessment occupies a central position in teaching, learning, acquisition of skills, knowledge, and certification in both the conventional mode of education and the open and distance learning mode of education. The role of assessment is not just to grade or rank the learners on the basis of their performance, but to increase their learning and development. Assessment techniques do work better if the assessment criteria and the learning outcomes are shared with the learners, informed to the learners in advance. Assessment creates a shared academic culture by assuring and improving the quality of teaching and learning. Assessment helps the administration, the teachers, the students to make plans and monitor their progress towards achieving the learning objectives. Assessment in ODL doesn't satisfy a single stakeholder. There are multiple users like the students, the teachers or the instructors, the institutions, and finally the community. Assessment in ODL is a multi-task activity because it involves self-assessment, peer assessment, formative assessment, and summative assessment. Assessment in ODL could be of various types. It could be formal or informal. It could be graded or ungraded. It could be spontaneous or it could be planned. It could be verbal, it could be non-verbal. It could be oral, it could be written. It could be embedded in the lesson plans. It could be standalone activities. It could be having open-ended responses. It could be having closed responses. It could be teacher-initiated or teacher-controlled. Or it could be student-initiated or student-controlled. It could be process-oriented or it could be product-oriented. But in this video, we shall be focusing on formative assessment and summative assessment as the two major modes of assessment. Formative assessment is a process used by the teachers to identify and recognize the strengths and weaknesses of the learners and take appropriate measures to improve their learning in line with the learning objectives. Second, formative assessment is a planned process used by the teachers to provide developmental feedback to the learners and to help them develop self-monitoring skills, reflect on and monitor their own progress, their own learning. The feedback that we give to the learners should be transparent, should be timely, should be consistent, should be actionable, and should be user-friendly. We can also provide feedback to the learners with the help of the online tools, particularly when they are not interacting with their teachers directly and they are learning on their own in the asynchronous environments. Formative assessment provides an effective and risk-free environment to the learners to learn and experiment. It assists the teachers to make changes to their teaching strategies, to adjust to the ongoing instructional needs and to benefit the learners. It can be tutor-led, it could be peer assessment, it could be self-assessment through different formats like quizzes, assignments, discussion forums, portfolios, conversations, etc. It could be efficiently and effectively carried out anytime, anywhere with the help of information and communication technologies if they are properly integrated and implemented. The formative assessment has different aims. Now let us see what are the different aims that formative assessment has. First of all, monitoring the progress of the students and providing them continuous feedback from time to time. Second, identifying the misconceptions and the learning gaps during teaching and learning, finding out the ways and means to help the learners by clearing the misconceptions and by closing the learning gaps, helping the learners find out and identify their strengths and weaknesses, and assisting them in banking upon their strengths and working on their weaknesses, promoting the students' learning and achieving learning objectives, enabling and engaging the students to construct and connect what they are learning to what they already know, empowering the students by inspiring them to take ownership of their own learning, enabling the students to change their learning behavior to adjust to the teaching learning process, helping the teachers to identify the areas where the learners are struggling and taking immediate steps to address these problems. The various kinds of formative assessments that we use in the ODL system are assignments, self-check exercises, self-assessment questions, quizzes, projects, seminars, group activities, micro-teaching, workshop-related activities, school-based activities, community participation. Likewise, there are so many activities that we can use for formative assessment. But there are some challenges in formative assessment. Now let us see what are they. First of all, it is very difficult to validate and authenticate the responses submitted by the learners, particularly while they submit the assignment responses. We cannot ascertain whether the responses submitted by them are really their own or not. It is also seen that the teachers who evaluate the assignment responses, they are very careless. Sometimes it so happens that the teachers, they assign the grades without giving any comments. In this case, what happens? The purpose of formative evaluation, it remains unfulfilled because we cannot link assessment with the learning and development of the learners. Second, sometimes the teachers, they are so careless that they award the grades without going through the assignments. They give same grades to many of the learners. And sometimes we also see that unauthorized people, they evaluate the assignment responses. All these things can be checked if we closely monitor the evaluation of assignment responses. Now let us see what is summative assessment. Summative assessment is evaluating students' knowledge, skills, proficiency and success at the end of an instructional period and comparing it with some benchmark or standard and certifying the students' performance. Evaluating the preparedness of the learners to go to the next academic level, evaluating the effectiveness of a program or a course based upon the performance of the learners, then sometimes we have seen that this summative assessment, it has high stakes because learners prefer it over the formative assessment modes. Summative assessment, it is assessment of learning because it aims to test what the learners have learned during a course, a program or a period of instruction. We also have problems during summative assessment tests. So what are the problems? The main problem is that sometimes we see the learners with low standards manage to get very good grades. Good learners, yeah, good writings, they get low grades. So we can attain objectivity in evaluation if we follow a few steps. Like first of all, by phrasing the essay questions properly and by making the responses restricted in terms of time and length, by providing model answers, yeah, ideal answers to the teachers to compare them with the responses of the students, by setting different kinds of questions like essay type questions, short answer type questions, objective type questions, by moderating the evaluated answers either fully or randomly by the experts, and finally by giving limited number of responses to the teachers. We usually find that summative assessment is carried out through term and examinations, dissertations, projects in the Viva Voce, final practical examinations and fieldwork journals. There are many more. Now let us see how formative and summative assessment they are connected. formative assessment, they let the learners know that they are learning. Summative assessments, they let the learners know what they have learned. The feedback received from the summative assessments, they can be used formatively by both the teachers and learners to guide their efforts and activities during the subsequent years. Formative assessments should be so designed that they contribute to summative assessment finally. This reduces the burden on the learners, and this also gives them necessary feedback from time to time so that they can improve their performance in course of time. Formative assessments should be spread over a period of time, but summative assessments should happen at the end of an year, semester or term. Finally, there should be a perfect balance between summative assessment and formative assessment so that we are able to maintain the quality of education. Thank you very much.